Welcome to this tutorial on how to simplify fractions. In this video, we'll walk you through the steps to simplify both proper and improper fractions. Simplifying fractions is a very important step when multiplying and dividing fractions. Check out those videos once you know how to simplify. To start, let's write down the fraction we want to simplify. Before we use real numbers, we'll use a placeholder fraction, a over b. If a over b is a proper fraction, or if a is less than b, we can simplify the fraction by dividing both the numerator and denominator by the greatest common factor, or GCF. If a over b is an improper fraction, if a is greater than b, we will first reduce the fraction using the GCF, and then convert the fraction to a mixed number. Let's look at the first scenario, where a over b is a proper fraction. For our first example, let's simplify the fraction 15 20ths. The GCF of 15 and 20 is 5, since 5 goes evenly into both the numerator and denominator. We will divide 15 by 5, which is 3, and do 20 divided by 5, which is 4. Our simplified fraction is 3/4. Next, let's simplify the fraction 42/49. In this example, 7 is the GCF of 42 and 49. Divide 42 by 7 to get 6, and divide 49 by 7 to get 7. Our simplified fraction is 6/7. Next, let's look at the second option for simplifying fractions, where we have an improper fraction. Or in other words, the numerator is larger than the denominator. Remember, in this case we have the extra step of converting the reduced fraction to a mixed number. To convert a fraction to a mixed number, divide the numerator by the denominator using long division with remainders. Write down the whole number result, and then use the remainder as the new numerator over the denominator. Let's do an example, 21/9. First, find the GCF. The greatest common factor of 21 and 9 is 3, so divide both 21 and 9 by 3. 21 divided by 3 is 7, and 9 divided by 3 is 3. So our reduced improper fraction is 7/3. Now convert to a mixed number. First, divide the numerator by the denominator using long division with remainders. 7 divided by 3 is 2 remainder 1. Write down 2 as the whole number result, and use 1 as the new numerator over 3. Our final simplified fraction is 2 1/3. Let's simplify the fraction 18/7 next. There is no GCF of 18 and 7, so we can go straight to converting the fraction to a mixed number. 18 divided by 7 is 2 remainder 4. We will write down 2 as the whole number result, and use 4 as the new numerator over the original denominator 7. So our answer is 2 4/7. Now that you understand how to simplify fractions, let's head over to calculatorsoup.com's fractions calculator to keep simplifying. The simplifying fractions calculator will simplify fractions and show you step by step how to get the answer. Let's do one more example, 26/8. After pressing the calculate button, you can view the steps to get the answer below. The greatest common factor of 26 and 8 is 2, so divide 26 by 2 to get 13, and divide 8 by 2 to get 4. Next, convert 13/4 to a mixed number. 13 divided by 4 is 3 remainder 1, so 3 is the whole number, and 1 is the new numerator over 4. Our simplified answer is 3 1/4. Now you know how to simplify fractions. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions or need further assistance, feel free to leave a comment below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more helpful tutorials from Calculator Soup.